Good afternoon and welcome back to the National Basketball Arena. We're about to get underway in the Subway All-Ireland Schools Under-16C Boys Final. It's between Kolochna-Nakorib and St. Vincent's Castleknock College. Joined for this one by Under-18 Men's Irish coach Conor James. Conor, good afternoon to you.
Good afternoon, Matt.
I'd ask you what we're expecting, but I'm sure, same as me, not really sure as yet.
Yeah, not too sure. I expect to see some nerves to start with and hopefully settle down after the first couple of minutes.
So Vincent's come up with the ball for the first possession. And first shot in the game is in for number 15, Jack Hensey.
A super shot there by Jack. That was just what they needed to kind of calm their nerves, and we did well to get into the paint and bank the shot home.
And Conor Obuda steps out of bounds for Carib, and I'll apologise straight off the bat for my pronunciation of an all-Irish group of names for Kolochna Carib.
I probably don't have any excuse, but I'll use it anyway.
And it's into the hands of Ross Newland. And it is Newland that takes first shot of the game. But again, we talked about those nerves and showing up again on that first shot.
Perhaps just a bit rushed. There was probably no need to take a shot so early on the shot clock. Maybe work the defense a bit better. And the same shot comes around when the defense has worked, it might be a bit easier to get it in.
So into the hands of Hensey, who made the first score for Castleknock. But good steal in the end, and it's Cronin McInvaird. Travel called. And it will be Castleknock ball. Roland Anoa bringing the ball up for Castleknock. And he makes a nice move to the basket and gets the roll. So it's Castleknock College that started the quicker as they lead 4-0. And a nice block from Anoa, but good rebound inside and a tough foul in the end there as Oisín O'Gormal.
Yeah, Oisín did very well there to, you know, a smaller man on the court, but showed a lot of determination to get that ball and was strong with it in hand. Made sure that if the only way he was going to knock the shot up was to be fouled.
So Oisín at the line, trying to open the account for Corb, and he can't do so. Don't forget, if you're watching back at school, you can get in contact with us on Twitter. It's at BballIRL. So at BballIRL and use the hashtag Subway Schools. Nice move inside. Again, this time from Newland. And it is Newland. Hensey looks to attract Vincent's and into the hands of number five, Fowl. Fowl gets past Gormley, takes a two, doesn't get it, and it is Oisín O'Gormal. A nice finish inside, and that's the first basket from open play.
He's had a few chances now, and he's been very determined getting into the middle, and thankfully that one paid off for him.
So Oisín O'Gormley with the first basket for Corb, and he has the ball in his hands again. He has people with him, but no need. Can't finish off the ball this time. It was a great move, but just a misplaced pass from Jack Hennessy. As we get our first subs of the game, and Oisín Tierney will check in for Castle Loch College. Corner three doesn't go for Cathal Maiden. And a jump ball. So far it seems to be all Oisin O'Gormley. A steal this time for Corb into the hands of McInvey, but he can't keep hold of it, and Castle Loch will come back with another chance.
It's just getting a bit sloppy here now. There's a few turnovers and some rush shots, not great options, but if they start to slow it down, maybe we might see the game progress a little bit better.
Gormley drives baseline, foul, goes against 13. Oscar Brown, it'll be his first. So 4 minutes to go in this one. 4-2 to Castle Loch College. Good defense from Corb, slowing down Castle Loch College, and again, good hands inside from Cahill O'Morgan. And the Castle Loch crowd just on cue as Oisin Tierney makes his first basket of the game.
Really tough shot for Oisin there. He did really well to finish it while still being under a bit of pressure, and even got a bit of contact there. So he was very, very unlucky not to get to the line as well, but a really good finish.
Hensey missed three. O'Gormley tries to find the open Martin O'Connell. And a travel called and the ghost close pressure. And we have our first timeout of the game, as it's Castle Loch College lead Kalashnikov on a scoreline of 6-2. Welcome back. 6-2. Castle Loch College. Connor, who's made the better start here?
Well, St. Vincent's have. Obviously, they've got more points on the board. They have been hitting some tough shots. Kalashnikov have been a bit unlucky when they've got into the middle. It just hasn't gone their way. If the shots start dropping for them, it could be a very even game coming down the stretch.
So the Castle Loch fans have started their singing. Inside by Onua, can't make it. Good rebound and outlet from Cahill O'Mardine. can't finish on the other end. And it's Jack Hensey decides to slow things down into the corner to an open Oisin Tierney. Can't get it, but rebounded nicely inside and great patience. The boys' first basket of the game, and it's 8-2.
Yeah, Roland on Uaha has been amazing on the boards, both ends for Castle Knock. And if he can keep that up and be a presence with his altering shots on defense, it could be a long day for Clash and Carver.
Oscar Brown this time wins the point for Castle Knock. Nice screen, but good defense inside from Clash and Carver, and a foul called. Gone against I think foul in the end was called against number 13 Connor Obuda, and he will take a break because that's his second foul, and into the game for the first time comes Martin O'Connelly. And a nice three outside from Oscar Brown.
Yeah, a great shot by Oscar Brown. And just creating a bit of separation now that Clash and Carver might be worried about. 11-2. And St. Vincent's really looked a more dangerous team.
So a chance of cutting that lead as Cronin or Morgan will go to the line for two. And Coach Jay Lyons, or Jer O'Lagheen, as it's pronounced, instead of can't make those from the line, and a three doesn't go, rebounded by O'Nulin. Back into the hands of St. Vincent's Castle Knock. They lead 11-2 here. Good rebound. And nice pass from O'Sheen, but can't be finished by Cathal O'Morgan. But he'll have another chance here as spinning ball on the outside. 3-point shot from Martin O'Connelly, but it can't go. And Connor coming towards the end of the first quarter, only 2 points on the board for Kolosh Nakoy. Will they be a little bit worried at the end of this quarter if they haven't got into their stride just yet?
Yeah, yes and no. I mean, the last possession they had there, they moved the ball really well and the shot just didn't go in. Other times they've been a bit rushed in the shots, like what happened to us there. But if they keep getting into the middle and keep making the right easy pass, the shots will be open, and sooner or later they'll start dropping.
Oisin Gormley is fouled. So the end line ball, 14.7 seconds to go in this first quarter. So they should have one more chance of a shot, and it will be a three. Goes from Conor McAvaird, got a nice rebound inside from O'Sheen, but can't finish. And with 2 seconds to go, St. Vincent's Castle Knock will hold the ball. And at the end of the first quarter, St. Vincent's Castle Knock will lead this under 16C All Islands Schools final on a scoreline of 11-2. Welcome back. The start of the second quarter. Score is 11-2. Long two-point shot. Doesn't go for Tierney, but they'll have another chance. But good defense from McCoyb. Nice shot. Nice touch this time for Manoa, and he makes a two as it's 13-2, and a good start in this second quarter for St. Vincent's.
He really deserved that basket. He worked incredibly hard trying to keep the rebound in play. He did, found a teammate, and was rewarded when he got the ball back and was able to just drop it in the net.
So if your teacher's been nice enough to let you watch, you might give him a shout out. It's at BballIOL. Using the hashtag Subway School, so at BballIOL. If you fancy giving us a bit of technique advice on how to pronounce some of these names, we'll take that as well. Out of bounds as we destroy the advertising hoarding. It'll be St. Vincent's Castleknock ball, 7:19 to go as they lead 13-2. Just got away with a little bit of a travel from Oscar Brown there, but he gets the ball back inside, and nice block from Cahill McAvaird.
McAvaird did very well there to get back. He was let go on a bit of a face cut and did really well to recover and block the shot out of bounds.
Anua was actually sitting on his bench when he caught that ball. Just a little bit out of bounds. Good ball movement, but Anua timed it perfectly. Throws that back up. Nice drive from Oisin Gormley, but doesn't get the call. Drive down the middle lane, and nice basket off the backboard from Cahill McAvaird.
Yeah, it was a really good drive, and they haven't swayed from what they've been trying to do all game, despite not putting the ball in the basket, and they're right to there, because getting right down the middle of the lane, and it's always the easiest place to score from.
And Anua has found his touch as he's back-to-back baskets for St. Vincent's.
He's been huge on both ends of the floor.
Three-point shot from Mordine, doesn't go. A nice move as he goes coast-to-coast for Oisin Tierney, gets another basket, and now all of a sudden things have picked up, but the score is not looking so good for Kolosnikov as they're down 17-4. Open three. Doesn't go. A nice move inside from Gormley, and he gets his first bucket.
Yeah, super. And the steal and the foul. He did really well there. He slowed down the steps to kind of put off the defender when he was trying to get blocked, and was wide awake to what was going on there in the inbound, able to steal it and draw the foul.
So we have a timeout call. 5:41 to go in this second quarter. It's St. Vincent's Castleknock leading 17-6. So it's Oisin Gormley. We'll have to silence the crowd here, which he's unable to do. but makes no mistake with the second. 10-point lead for St. Vincent's Castle Knox, 17-7.
Hopefully St. Vincent's Castle Knox can build a bit of momentum now. It's 3 points in a row, and if they can get a couple of stops in a row, they might get back into this game.
Out of bounds. And it will be a steal for the recently checked in Ronan Barrett. As Oisin Gormley's pass goes astray, here's Barrett again. Hence he finds teammate Brown, but Brown can't hit. Gormley driving off the races there. No one's going to catch him as Oisin Gormley gets another bucket.
Yeah, he really powered through the two defenders that were kind of trying to stop him at the halfway line and got out in the open floor. And they've just stepped up their defense now. They're making St. Vincent's Castle Knox shoot outside shots. Commentator's curse just there, but the two defense proves that they were excellent and were able to get out in transition.
Nice basket by Elvis Duo. Gets an offensive rebound and puts it back in. And Gormley is starting to show his presence a little bit in this game and keeping Kanosh McCorrib in the game. Rebound from Anua, has the ball in his hand. They decide to leave him alone. He made his last two from that distance. That one goes in and out, but rebound from Barrett. And Barrett gets his first bucket of the game.
Yeah, Kloshin Akar won't be happy with doing the second chance points they're giving up. Amazing basket there.
Mac Unverd.
Took the contact and finished really well with his offhand.
Shot from Duo, doesn't go. Rebound from McInverd, and he finds eventually to an open Gormley, beautiful touch down the lane, and now we seem to have a little bit of a basketball game.
Yeah, he really had a nice cut down the lane as his teammate was able to find him, and he finished softly at the rim.
Good stand on defense. McInverd gets the ball. He's Gormley up in front of him. Gormley easily evades the defense but can't finish, gets his own rebound, and he finds wide open Martin O'Connolly but doesn't get it. McInverd rebounded again, doesn't go, and good defense from Duo just puts him off.
Yeah, Coach Sherline's not too happy with ref Joe Robinson's there on the no call. Let him hear about it, and fortunately a bit of a 4-point swing there.
Anua, another fantastic basket for him. This time they do get the call, and that will go against Barrett.
I think Kloshin Akar will be happy enough now that the ball started to go in for them. If they can just step it up a little bit on defense now, not give up so many second chance points, they'll take a bit of confidence going into halftime.
Straight down the middle of the lane, and another great finish inside from McInverd. And at this point, I'm hoping he's left-handed. If he's not, it's two fantastic left-hand finishes.
He's making it look easy, all right.
Couple of misses inside. Barrett can't get it. Buddy shows great fight in keeping the offensive boards alive.
Yeah, it's still, there's four offensive rebounds there, and just giving a team that many chances to score per offense, they're eventually going to put the ball in the basket.
Travel called. And a chance to cut into the lead again. They're back to within seven here. .231 to go in the Subway All-Ireland Schools under 16C final. Nice move again down the middle of the lane by Cahill O'Magin.
Yeah, it just seemed to separate there for him, and a bit too easy from the defense. They won't be too happy giving up a score like that.
Good rebound for Martin O'Connolly. And again, the silky skills of O'Mordine. He'll have a three. doesn't go. Great rebound and drive and lovely finish from Martin O'Connolly, and all of a sudden it's a 3-point game.
Yeah, great move. He's starting to get a bit amped here now. He's banging his chest, but it was a great play, and he did really well to finish and take the contact as well. And all of a sudden, with a chance to make it a two-point game, and given that it was 17-4 at one point, it's a huge quarter for Clash and Corriba.
Good rebound from Anua, but can't hold on to it. But actually, it was Dua with a rebound, and nice block inside from, I think, McInvade, and getting silky skills from Clash to Corriba. Can't get it in the end, but again, some great stuff from Oisin Gormley, but can't quite finish at the end of his teammate. Open three, Oisin Tiernan, doesn't go. Conan McAvey finds long two from Cathal O'Mordin. Three-point shot goes up from Jack Hennessy. Doesn't go. Good hands inside.
And silly foul there. That's going to be two shots.
And we've a timeout here as St. Vincent's Castle Knox just want to talk this over. So welcome back. 55 seconds to go in this first half. It will be Cathal O'Mordin going to the line. So not long to half time, gone at her up and down first quarter. Who's going to be the happiest of the coaches?
Yeah, you probably have to think the Chair Lions of Clash and Carver is going to be the happier of the coaches. I mean, they had a really poor start, but they showed a lot of grit and determination to get themselves right back into this game. A 2-point possession. And at the end of the first quarter, if you offered him a 2-point game at halftime, he absolutely would have taken it.
Again, good defense. And here comes Gormley, showing his speed again. Oh, and clattered from behind. Crowd boo, but perfectly accidental. But old Gormley will go to the line for two. And a chance to tie the game.
Yeah, it seems to be Gormley's game, just getting out in transition. He's obviously very quick, and he's a good finisher around the rim, so if he can keep doing that, you can assure that there'll be some more easy scores or else free throws.
Misses both, and the chance to tie. Floater goes up. Mosca Brown doesn't go. And Gormley will have another chance to tie the game here. He goes straight down the middle. And again, he's fouled, but again, can't quite finish. So he'll need to earn the hard way from the foul line on this occasion.
Yeah, I think St. Vincent's Castle Knock, just when Oisin gets the ball in transition, they just need to start clogging up the key. He hasn't been too great from outside the key in terms of his shooting, but if they don't clog up the key, he's going to keep getting to the foul line or getting easy layups.
Makes one of two. Rebound by Gwobi and Onoa all the way down the lane, and he shows that soft touch that we've seen fairly often in this first half. And it's a 3-point game with 7 seconds to go in this first half. And McInverd takes a deep three to tie it, doesn't go, and on the buzzer at the end of the first half of the Subway All-Ireland Schools Cup final, under 16 Seaboys. The score is St Vincent's Castle Knock 25, Kalashnikov 22. Welcome back. We're just about to start the third quarter of the Subway All-Ireland Schools Cup Under-16C Boys Final. Here we go. Oisin O'Gormley, who had a great first half for Kolosnikov. And Connor, as we see a three looking to tie it, doesn't go, but O'Gormley gets a steal. Nice pass inside, but can't be finished this time from O'Connolly. Going to the second half, both coaches had a chance to talk things over. Do you think there'll be much change, or will it be more of the same? And what will the coaches have been talking about during the break?
Well, you'd like to think that St. Vincent's Castleknock have talked about not giving up so much transition baskets. And if they can stop that, it's a huge part of Kolosnikov's game. Jerry Lyons for Kolosnikov will probably have talked about second chance opportunities for St. Vincent's Castleknock. And again, if they can limit those opportunities, then they have a really good chance of winning this game.
Fake three, but good defense from Anua, and it will be end line ball. Gormley threads the needle inside, open three, decides not to take it, but O'Connolly will take it.
Some really nice ball movement and definitely taking the right shot. Unfortunately not to go down that time, but if they stick with it, I'm sure a few of them will start dropping.
A big crowd just filing in down below us. They're here for the next game, which as the boy gets his second basket of the half and extends the lead again by seven. Next game, of course, the under-16B girls final, Kolosnikov Oriel versus Cross and Passion Kilcullen. As the boy who we've barely mentioned in the first half, I'd remember as I savage his name, has had a great start to this second half, couple of blocks and two scores.
Yeah, he's been big. The block shots are huge. It's if they can get in, and all of a sudden a 5-point game to a 7-point game, and pretty much down to the one man himself.
Just off the foot of McCoy, so it will remain St. Vincent's Castleknock ball. Good steal by O'Morgan, finds Gormley, who has support in the size of Connolly. O'Connolly, and similar to the first half, Kolosnikov just started off slower than St. Vincent's Castleknock, hence the scoreline as a travel is called there. And again, similar to this first quarter, Nakoyev could really use a score early in this one.
Yeah, it's just been a combination of being unlucky, taking the right shots, but just getting them, not having them drop for them, and then also just maybe some poor decisions. There've been a few turnovers now that have been converted into points in the other end, and they'll need to stop those turnovers if they've any chance of getting back in this game. And turnovers like that, I'm afraid, are not going to cut it.
So stolen by Kolosnikov, but turned over down the other end. Can't punish St. Vincent's Castleknock, and they'll take their 7-point lead back down the floor with 5:15 to go, and the ball in the hands of Jack Hensley. But good steal by Connolly. He's looking for numbers, gets in the hands of Gormley. Oh, Gormley off the glass. He makes a two and cuts the lead to five.
Yeah, super take. He saw the long irons of Noby there and just decided to step back and hit a little pop shot.
And back-to-back baskets for Gormley as he gets his hands on the steal, finishes off the glass for two, and cuts the lead back down to three.
And that's what he does, just get out in transition, get the easy baskets.
Nice drive down the lane from Oisin Tierney. Extends the lead back to five.
Super finish by number eight, Margin. And he's been actually a bright spark for them. He's some super passing, and he's getting to the basket himself too.
Timeout taken with 4:30 to go. So welcome back. We have a three-point game here. 31-28. So Noah tries to force him way inside. Doesn't go. And great defense from Keneally. Oh, Keneally, who eventually steals with a travel called. I think on Ocean Gormley.
And it he was unlucky there. He, looking backwards to see the ball, didn't see the man in front of him forward, and unfortunately resulted in a travel and another turnover.
Oscar Brown, he's made a three already. Step back three, doesn't go. And a jump ball called, and it will stay St. Vincent's Castle lock possession. Nice pass back, three. Doesn't go for Anua. And we're still 3-point game. Oisin Ogormley, nice pass in the corner. Another good move inside from McInverd, but can't finish, but a foul is called. And it will be two shots.
Yeah, it was a nice strong rebound from Keneally there, and couldn't put it in, but sufficient contact to draw the foul.
Can't make the first. But gets a nice roll for the second. And we're back to a two-point game.
It's as close as it's been since the opening basket, so Clash of Carver have to be happy here. They started slow this quarter and have slowly clawed their way back once more.
But Hensey makes sure that that is not the case as he hits a three. And followed up by a steal and off the races with Anua. Just gets in the corner, nice move down the baseline and beautiful finish inside from Anua. And all of a sudden when they were back to two, it's all of a sudden back up to a 7-point lead. Ocean Ogormley was back and forth trying to find some space, can't find it, but eventually gets it in the hands of O'Noodlin. Good defense from Carson Locke and a smart piece of work from Ogormley, throwing it off the leg.
Yeah, Clash Carva seem to be shooting themselves in the foot a little bit. They keep getting themselves back into the game, and just as you think they might go ahead, they give up some easy scores, and they're going to have to work a bit extra hard. Now, time's not going to be on their side if that keeps happening to them.
Foul by Gavoy, and it will be Cronin McInverd that goes to the line for two shots. Makes that one, and it's 36-31, 2:45 to go. Oscar Brown decides against the three, finds Hensey in the corner. Good rebound from Anua, but can't get it back to Oscar Brown. Again, don't get it, and again rebound from Anua, but can't make it. And Hensey is fouled.
You're going to keep giving up that many offensive rebounds, they're eventually going to score, like we said earlier. So Coach Gerlines won't be too happy, and I can see him now signaling to the table for a timeout. Maybe discuss that, talk it over.
So he didn't get the timeout in time, so I think he'll now cancel it. But gets away with one there as Jack Hensey missed the first free throw and the second, and a good rebound from Cuthall Morgan, and he gets it forwards to Keneally. Oh, but good hands from Anua. Splits the defense. Beautiful finish off the glass for 2 points. And he's shown that soft touch throughout the game. And we have a timeout here as St. Vincent's Castle Knock lead Knosh na Corrib on a scoreline of 38-31. So back underway, just over 2 minutes to go in this third quarter. It's St Vincent's Castleknock leading 38-31. O'Gormley takes no time in getting back in the swing of things with a nice floater down the middle of the lane. It's 38-33.
He's been very smart. He knows when he's not in transition, getting those easy baskets, that he knows he has to get into the lane. So if he can't score himself, he can at least can create floaters.
Good quick hands from O'Gormley, but can't keep it in. Just put his toe on the line. So it'll be back in the hands of Jack Hensey for Castleknock, but a bit of pressure here. Good defense from Tosh McCoy, but backdoor pass, nice catch from Tierney, but Tierney is called for the travel.
Yeah, maybe a bit unlucky there not to get called for a foul. Seemed to be a lot of contact on the hand, but the referee blew a travel, and the referees are always right.
Some dead air, no one answers. Long two. Oh, superb long two from McInvaird, and he had a good first half. Been a little quiet in the second half offensively, but makes his first basket of the half. Yeah, and we're back to three.
They're the shots they've been taking the whole game, they just haven't dropped. And you know, it's coming into crunch time now at the end of the third. And if they can get those shots to drop, they have a really good chance of winning this game.
Oh, great hustle. Como Corneli takes a bang in the head, but gets nothing more than the jump ball. And it will be their ball, though, so he is rewarded on the possession hour. It's a three-point game, as it has been a few times in this second half. And a chance for Knostakov to take a lead or to tie or get within one. Might have just got away with the travel there. Good defense. Somehow or other, Corneli keeps hold of it. Open in the corner is McInvaird. He does take a three. And for the first time since 0-0, we are tied.
Another huge shot by McInvaird. And like you said earlier, those shots like that keep on dropping. And they can start playing some defense, limited second chance opportunities. They've got a really good chance this game. St. Vincent seemed to have gone a little bit cold.
Oh, Gormley was off to the races there. But a foul is called with 2.7 seconds to go on the clock, so.
Yeah, smart foul, stop with them in transition with 2 seconds to go. Make sure that they have to take a tough shot before the buzzer goes.
And St. Vincent do push up full court, but they've left Corneli wide open. He gets it off the backboard, doesn't go. So at the end of the third quarter in the Subway All-Ireland Schools Cup final, under 16 C boys, it's St. Vincent's Castleknock 38. Knostakov Cobb 38. So here we go, start of the fourth quarter of the under 16C Subway All-Ireland Schools Cup Final. Connor, we're back where we started, tie ball game. Who do you see coming out on top on this one?
Oh, I have to say the momentum is with Clash and Caraba. It's all going to depend who gets the first couple of baskets. I mean, if there's a lead of more than two baskets here, then time is of the essence, and you have to fancy the team that's leading.
Nice block inside, but falls into the hands of O'Gormley. Throws up left, he doesn't get it. Anua with a rebound, and he'll be the man at Castleknock. St. Vincent's Castleknock will be looking to make things happen. Travel called. As Tierney just loses his footing. Don't forget this summer, if you're an avid basketball fan, Basketball Islands National Camp will take place in Gormanston Park, County Meath. The weeks of July the 9th to the 14th and July the 16th to the 21st. Although Connolly can't score inside, and off to the races is Hensey, but can't finish that one. And O'Connolly is alone. Takes possibly the worst shot in basketball as he stands firmly 2 feet on the line. But when they go in, Connolly, you don't really care.
A good shot is a shot that goes in, no matter where it's from.
And no one looks to a turn, and he finds his score and touches. He just says, we're not going to be behind for long, and knocks down a three. O'Gormley looks to answer back, but can't do it. And O'Connolly, great dive on the ball, but all of a sudden, everyone's a three-point shooter. Oh, a beautiful fadeaway from O'Gormley, and they retake the lead.
Yeah, O'Gormley really is a soft touch around the basket. I mean, there's some really difficult shots he's taken, particularly not using the backboard, but really soft touch, and probably the game's top scorer at this point.
Jack Hensey can't connect from the three-point line. So for Basketball Islands Camp, bookings will be open from February the 1st. Get all your information and booking forms from basketballisland.ie. Great opportunity to meet people, play basketball 24/7, meet people from all over, coaches from USA, from Europe, and from Ireland. A chance to hone in your school or skills. Also, don't forget, coming up this weekend, the showpiece event, Hula Hoops National Cup Finals here in the Basketball Arena. Tickets available on basketballisland.ie. Men's Super League Final live on TGK, 8 p.m. on Saturday night, and that will be followed on Sunday at 5 p.m. by the Women's Hula Hoops National Cup Final. And a foul called against McInverd as he fouls Anua.
Yeah, St. Vincent's Castleknock just being smart here. They knew they had to find Oahu to have the best chance to score, and they found him in an isolation in the post, and he drew the foul. Unfortunately missed the first free throw, but a chance now to tie it.
Doesn't go, but huge rebound. As boy, sky's above everyone, but a jump ball is called, and on the possession hour it will be Kaloshan Nakori. Ball, and here comes Cuthel O'Morgan. Inside O'Noodlin. Nice fake. Lovely fake from McInverd. And McInverd extends the lead to a three-point game.
I think he heard you say he was quiet so far in the second half, because he's been huge now since he said that. He's had three really big baskets.
Open three from Brown. Doesn't get it, but another rebound from Manoa.
He's been huge on the boards today.
Yeah, I don't want to put pressure on you, Connor, but you'll have to pick the MVP, and it's going to be a hugely difficult job with a couple of players on both teams having good performances so far.
Yeah, well, I think I'll give it a few more minutes. The game's still a bit too close to call right now.
Makes that free throw, cuts it to a two-point game. O'Morgan looking for someone. Oisin O'Gormley. Oh, beautiful touch inside from O'Gormley. Banks it in over the outstretched hands of Anua, and extends the lead, 4-point lead, biggest lead of the game so far for Kalashnikov.
Yeah, Gormley maybe a bit quiet for the last 3 or 4 minutes, and Kalashnikov, I've obviously got a couple of guys who stepped up in the meantime, but once they need to go back to him, he's ready to take the shot on.
Good steal from Gormley. Shows a bit of handles here. That's nice cool head at the end of the day. Gets it back into the hands of Maureen, and he'll have it again, but good defense from St. Vincent's cast, not giving away anything easy. Good ball movement, just stays in bounds. Connolly maybe got away with a shuffling of feet and a shot clock violation called. So just under four minutes to go. It's 46-42, and we'll have a timeout from St. Vincent's Castle Knock with Kalashnikov leading by 4, 46-42. So, 4 minutes to go. It's Kalashnikov have come from as many as 13 down to lead by 4, 46-42 over St. Vincent's Castle Knock. But the game is very much still alive. Onoa, who made his last, so he doesn't make that one, but grabs his own rebound inside. Nice footwork. Another two for Onoa.
And another second chance opportunity. We said it was huge on the boards, and this time able to get the rebound and get the score too.
Oh, Connolly can't find O'Nordlin, and it's back in the hands of that man, Onoa. But this time, good defense from Kalashnikov, just forced to travel. But full court pressure here from Vinton's, but it's led to a 2-on-1. And it's O'Morveen finds Connolly inside, but somehow or other, no foul call. There's four players land on top of each other, and backcourt violation. And as the game speeds up, people just starting to make a few more mistakes as the pressure comes on a little bit.
It's getting a bit scrappy, all right. Not surprised by that timeout call. Maybe slow things down. You still have the lead. Maybe take a bit of a longer possession.
We'll be back with you shortly. So here we go, 3:15 to go. Martin O'Connolly gets it into the hands of Jacko Mordine, but turnover. Oh, definite. Oscar Brown got away with a double dribble there as he put his hand on the ball. Another long two, but that seems to be the way to go as Jack Hensey ties the game at 46 apiece.
Yeah, cool as you like, nothing but now.
O'Connolly, nice drive inside. Chased down from Norlin and a foul called. I think it's against Brown, but no one in the penalty as yet. That's the first foul in this final quarter for St. Vincent's Castlenock. So it'll be an end line ball. Keneally blocked by Aubrey, and Anua calls a jump ball, and it will be St. Vincent's Castlenock ball. Anua escapes his own players there as they get in his way a little bit. Can't find anywhere to go. Finds Oscar Brown. Oscar Brown gets a bit of space but can't go through the defence, and is into the hands of McInverd. Nice move from Gormley, but just can't finish. And the length inside for St. Vincent's Castlenock, proving tough. Travel call, so at the most important part of the game, scores proving difficult to come by. There's a bit of nerves being shown. It's 46 all, 2 minutes to go.
Yeah, definitely some nerves, but they've just got to find someone who's going to step up and take the shot.
And O'Nordland can't make that, but good defence. Oh, nice silky skills as it's that man. Anua gets through the defence, and he's the one who breaks the deadlock and St. Vincent's lead by two, but Gormley wasting no time, come back and answer, but again, great defence. So Norling does a good job of getting the scrappy rebound, and foul is called. It'll be end line ball to Konosnikov as they try and tie this one up.
Yeah, some great footwork down the far end by Anuahu, trying to weave through the defence to score that layup. And with a minute and a half left, he's put St. Vincent's Castlenock back up for the first time in this quarter.
And Oscar Brown, unfortunately, just fouled out there for St. Vincent's Castlenock, so they've had to make a change, and it's Barrett, I believe, that has come onto the floor. It is Ronan Barrett. Great basket there to tie the game again, and there's nothing between these two teams as we tick down towards the 1 minute, 1 minute 15 to go. Here is Ronan Barrett looking to evade the defense here, but back into Anua. Long three. Oh, that's huge as he wipes the floor. Massive three from Anua. Yeah. And timeout called. So 1 minute four to go in the 16C Subway All-Ireland Schools Cup final. And McInverd, a chance to go to the basket and tie, and he's fouled by Anua. And Connor just pulled the timeout there. Massive three by Ouj Roland Anouye. Is that going to be the basket that decides this game, or is there still plenty left to happen?
There's still plenty of time. Obviously, it was a huge basket. He must have been 3 or 4 feet outside the three-point line. Two shots here. Even if he can hit one of them, game's still on.
And he does exactly that as McInverne makes the two-point game and the pressure on from across the Corrib. Barrett and a travel possibly there.
No, Matt, referees are always right.
You're right there, I forgot that. A score here. Hands up. Oh, he looks to push. Chance to tie it with.
Yeah, he's out of play, but.
They'll want this to keep them in the game, or an offensive rebound. Fails to connect, and it will be sideline ball. So now a timeout is called from St. Vincent's Castle Knock with 22.8 to go. And they lead by 2, 51 to 49. So here we go, 22.8 seconds to go. Down two. Kloshtakov will have to make something happen. They do, they foul. But they've only two team fouls, so they'll have to repeat the process before sending, or twice more, before sending Vincent to the line. But they'll be looking for the steal first, and they get it. Keneally, can he finish? Oh, huge block. The bench goes crazy from Gaboy, who turned the ball over in the first place, but skyrocketed to get that one down, but it will still remain. Kloshtakov ball, 16 seconds to go. What will be looking to happen here, Connor?
You got to get the ball in Gormley's hands and let him just get into the lane and make a decision.
It is in the hands of Gormley. He does get into the lane, and he's fouled, and he will go to the line. The basket does not count. Whistle went first. He'll have to earn them the hard way. And that will be the end of this afternoon's game for Jack Hensey, fouled out on five fouls. So into the game comes Lewis Fowle. His first action of the day, so a little bit of nerves there. First one doesn't go. Still plenty of time, score or miss, 13.3 to go. And he slots that second one, 1 point game. Pressure on. Oh, great hands, but it's saved. And into the hands of Barrett. And a foul called, and unlucky for Kloshtakov. They nearly had their hands on the ball, but a great save. I think it was Oisin Tierney in the end, just saved it from going out of bounds. And 8 seconds go, 1 point game, and pressure on from Kloshtakov.
And stolen
by O'Morbin. Gets it forward to Oisin O'Gormley. Gets the ball up, doesn't go, and time will run out on this one. And a gutted. Oshino Gormley falls to the floor as a jubilant St. Vincent's Castle knock. One under the floor, hugging each other. Fantastic game of basketball. Connor, just quickly sum that one up for us.
Yeah, super game. You have to feel sorry for Clash of the Car, but they, you know, almost get the steal, then they do get the steal. Time was obviously not on their side, and they just had to throw up a rush shot and unfortunate to someone who's been a super player all day for Gormley, it just didn't go in. But all credit to St. Vincent's Castleknock. They went up, they went down, and eventually fought it out to win a really tough game and a really enjoyable game to watch.
And give us your MVP of the game.
The MVP is going to be from St. Vincent's Castleknock, number 10, Og Roland Onuaha.
Yeah, fantastic game of basketball there. So stay with us for the presentations. We'll be going off air, but you'll be able to watch them online. And we'll be back in about 10, 15 minutes' time with the under-16B girls' final, Colchester Oriel versus Cross and Passion Kilcullen.